The main body of this model can be created by a simple loft using a pair of slot sketches. Let's ignore the ribs for the moment and take a look at the cross section. The main body is shelved internally. There is an indentation here which is shelved from the outside. So how can we create a shell that is both internal and external to the model? That is one of the challenges we will be confronting in this case study. Next, let's take a look at the ribs. The top surface of the ribs actually has a curvature to it. We will take a look at how that can be done. The main body was created by a loft between two slot profiles. A part of the main body was then split and removed. For the moment, let's not worry about how to create this indentation. Let's just shell this main body as though the indentation isn't there. Go to Modify, Shell. In the shell feature, we need to pick on faces. We can visualize this by imagining the solid body as a container that is full of water. What are the faces that I need to open up in order to let the water flow out and expose the insides of the container? So I need to select the top face as well as these faces created by the split line to open this container up. With the tangent chain option checked, these three faces will be selected together. Select the top face as well. Adjust the shell thickness. Just as a side note, if I need to create a shell like this, with the hollow all the way through, I would have to select this face as well. Now is a good time to take a look at the final product. Let's roll the timeline back to before the ribs were created, and take a look at the cross section. When faced with a feature like this, we might think of creating a sketch profile like so. That is definitely an option. Often, we need to remind ourselves to think of a model in the simplest way possible in order to reduce the complexity of the sketches. In this case, this is just a cuboid with a rather large fillet that terminates against the curved surface of the shell main body. Let's not worry about the fillet and the curved surface of the shell, and just sketch a simple rectangle on the base of the main body. Perform an extrude with this profile and set the operation to join. We want this to be merged with the existing body. So how do we get rid of the excess of the cuboid that protrudes out of the back of the main body? The following method might come as a surprise. Simply pick on these surfaces and hit the delete key. Fusion intelligently recognizes that you are trying to get rid of the excess and trims off the cuboid, leaving a smooth surface. Let's add in the major fillet at this point, and also some small fillets. It is important to add in these small fillets at this juncture, so that when we do the shedding on the outside, the shell would follow these fillets. Next, we need to hollow out this indentation from the outside. Go to Modify, Shell. So what are the faces that we need to open up in this case? It will be these two faces. Select them and adjust the thickness. Let's take a look at the cross section. So now that we have tackled this composite shell, we shall go on to create the ribs. If we take a look at the final product, the top face of the ribs actually has a curvature to them. Let's not worry about that, and just create basic ribs with a flat, planar face. We know that the top face of the rib is slightly under this top face of the main body, so let's create an offset plane. Create lines on this plane, which we can use later in the web feature. With the web feature, we don't need to extend the lines all the way to the edges. Once the sketch is complete, go to Create Web, and start picking on the sketched lines to act as the curve. For depth options, select Who Next, and the feature would automatically extend the ribs down to the base. Checking the Extended Curves option would automatically extend the ribs to the surfaces on the side and to the indentation. Adjust the thickness and the thickness direction according to your liking. To create a curved surface on the top of the ribs, we shall turn to the Replace Face feature. To begin, let's create a sketch on the front plane. This will be in the form of an arc. It can just as easily be a spline. Make sure that the arc fully extends beyond the ribs. After the sketch is done, activate the surface tab and extrude the surface out until it fully encompasses the ribs. This is crucial for the replace face command to work. It does not matter whether the surface is above, below, or even cut through the existing ribs. Activate the solid tab, go to modify, replace face. For source faces, select the surface that you need to be replaced, which in this case will be the top face of the rib. For target faces, select the newly created curved surface. Let's hide the surface. You can see that the top face of every single rib has been completely replaced by the curved surface.